My novel Beyond the Sea is the story of two South American fishermen who go to sea out in the Pacific before a storm. One of the fishermen is told that there's going to be a storm, but he chooses to ignore it. And the storm comes and they find themselves set adrift without any hope of being rescued. And they are at the mercy of the ocean currents, taking them deeper, further out into the Pacific Ocean. And so the book becomes this, at the surface it's a survival story because they want to survive. But deeper down it's an existential story because it's the two men start to question things that they would not think about if they were at home. Suddenly they are cut off from society, cut off from the world, and they are confronted by themselves. And so each man starts to search within himself for who he truly is. And the book explores two very different aspects of these two characters and how they deal with it. And it asks questions about faith. How do we continue to believe that we're going to be rescued? How do we create hope to fight against despair? And one of them fails to do this while the other one does. There's a huge challenge as a writer to take two characters and surround them by an infinity of silence. The challenge is enormous because the characters cannot be entertained by anything other than what they're trying to do to survive, but also what they do in terms of how they speak to each other. And as the characters start to descend into their own forms of despair or madness, often the other character will try and lean in and pull one of them back. And they are very different characters. One of them, Bolivar, is a man who begins the book this indifferent, ironic individual who does not care. He doesn't care to the extent that he actually takes the teenage boy out with him before the storm when he knows there's going to be a storm. And whereas Hector is this innocent teenager who doesn't know really very much about fishing. And so the book is fundamentally really about how Bolivar changes, because Bolivar does not resist the struggle of surviving. He adapts to it. He adapts to life on the ocean, whereas Hector struggles, and Hector wants to be back home, but he's not back home. He doesn't want to be on the boat, but he's on the boat, and so he's nowhere. And so these two characters are constantly assessing who they are, and it gets very messy. My books do tend to take on big metaphysical questions about what is in a human being. You know, Dostoevsky once said, how much human being is in a human being? I like that question. I think that through great trials, we begin to see what's truly inside a person, what sort of character emerges, how we cope, how we imagine ourselves, how we speak to our own suffering. And the interesting thing for me as a writer is that through suffering, there is wisdom. And it's those little pearls of wisdom that I'm trying to find. I wrote the book because I was inspired by a true story, and I took the bones of the true story and turned it into a Paul Lynch novel, infused with my own mythology, my own sense of the world that I want to create. And the reason that I was really attracted to this story, it seized hold of me, and it's because I could see in a moment that this was an existential vacuum, that I was able to create a space of silence where the two men are faced, they're alienated on this boat. And we are all alienated in various ways. And we are alienated in our relationships, we are alienated in the world, we are alienated from God. That's a very modern problem. And fiction used to deal with this problem. Fiction used to confront the alienation of modern man. And then fiction sort of gave up on this problem because it seemed too absurd. It seemed we could not solve this problem. But this book seemed to me an opportunity to take two characters and place them in a silent universe where we hear nothing. And so this silence becomes this enormous part of the book. Thank you.